Hey everyone, welcome to Comet. My name is Gretel. I am customer success for the team, and in this video, I will be walking you through how to get started on a self-hosted Comet server. Just to recap, you can either let Comet host the server, or you can self-host it in your own physical or virtual environment. This is suited for maximum flexibility and might be the only option if you have very strict and specific security requirements. On a self-hosted server, you can control your setup by utilizing your own infrastructure. Otherwise, you can use the Comet-Hosted server, which is our recommendation, as it's the fastest and easiest way to get started. Okay, that was just a quick recap on your options for hosting the Comet server. Now let's move on to the actual setup process. After signing up, you can choose to use either a Comet-Hosted or a self-hosted server from the My Servers page. Choose the self-hosted option here. Select your platform here to download the Comet server. Our system requirements guide is linked below for your reference. Take note that when running the Windows installer, you will get a wizard setup to configure the default options. On Linux, this wizard is not available, but these options can be changed on the web interface. So I am choosing Windows, and then I'm just going to click on download. And now that the download's complete, let's install the server. Just open the installer and follow the prompts. These will set up Comet with default settings, but you can always change these later. Click on I agree. Then choose the folder where you would like to install your server. Just click on next here. The setup wizard should pop up automatically if this is your first time installing the Comet server. Otherwise, on the server installer, click on setup wizard. Click on next here. In this window, log in with the username and password you had created when you signed up for your Comet account. Logging in here will activate your server. Then click on Next to move on. This next screen is where we can configure the network settings for the server web interface. Choose a network interface, protocol, and port for your server to be reached on. You can use the default HTTP option to get started, but for production use, we recommend using the HTTPS automatic option, which will request a certificate from Let's Encrypt to create a secure connection with the client devices. The automatic option requires the server to be listening on port 443, the domain name must be publicly accessible, and the DNS for the domain name must point to the specific Comet server instance. In this video, I'll just choose the default HTTP option. Now, here, we're creating the admin account we'll use to manage the web server. At this point, you will be assigned the generic username and password admin in lowercase. You can change these credentials later. For now, let's click on Next to move on. Here, I'm just going to choose Disabled, then come back and add storage locations later. Side note, if you are planning on using Backblaze or Wasabi Cloud Storage and prefer to have the backup data transferred directly from the backup client to the cloud provider, then choose Disabled on this step and follow our Backblaze or Wasabi setup guide when you have access to your web interface. And we're done. Click on Finish. Then from the setup wizard, you will be taken to the web interface login. Remember, your username and password is lowercase admin, and you can change this later. Let me log in to show you the next part of the setup process. This is how the Comet server web interface looks like. This is where you can manage all of your customers and their backups and deploy your own personally white-labeled backup client. You're also able to remotely perform all actions to the backup client from your Comet server and even remotely browse a device to select files to be included in a backup. You can refer to the guide in this bar for instructions on how to complete your setup. As you can see, the next steps are to add a user, and download and install the client software, which are all covered in a separate video linked below. And that's it. We've successfully downloaded and installed the self-hosted Comet server. Thank you for watching. Please check out the links below to access reference guides and related video demos, and visit our website to get in touch. See you again next time.